In today's video, Onision gets deplatformed from Patreon after doxing Billy. Will the others follow suit? And the FBI officially opens up a case to investigate Onision and Kai. Those stories coming up now. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day today. If you're a return subscriber, I really do appreciate your continued support. If you're new here and you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Everyone give this video a big thumbs up, click on that notification bell and select it to all. That way you'll be notified when I upload my next video. Before we get started, and as always, I do need to remind you guys that I am a drama commentary channel. I have opinions and I speak them freely. Opinions are not facts, they never have been facts, and they never will be facts. And because of the nature of this video, I do need to also remind you guys that all this information in my video is alleged. I cannot prove nor deny anything. All the information in my video is alleged. This video also may be very triggering for some, so if you are sensitive to certain topics, please click off now. Now that I've gotten that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive in. On November 20th, Chris Hansen continued his investigative series on Onision and Kai by interviewing Billy. Billy became interested in Onision when coming across his YouTube channel at 15 years old. Billy would watch videos where Onision discussed body hair and rated the style of scene kids, but never reached out to either Onision or Kai for private conversation. When Billy was 18 years old, Kai sent a direct message to Billy out of the blue. Billy said that Kai must have found a picture of them on either Instagram or Twitter and took an interest. Kai sent Billy a message asking if Billy was interested in dating girls, and Billy replied with yes. After that, the messages became centered around having a potential relationship and flirting. After talking back and forth for 2 weeks, Kai offered to fly Billy out to Washington State to see if their relationship could work, and Billy agreed. When Billy met Onision for the first time, it was awkward. He didn't say hello and just told Billy to leave shoes at the door. Only one day into the visit, and Onision was already putting pressure on Kai and Billy to kiss, even though they had just met in person. When they finally did kiss, Onision was allegedly right there, which completely creeped out Billy. Billy said that during the second kiss, Onision took a picture of them and posted it to Instagram. During Billy's second visit, Onision started putting pressure on them to have a three-way relationship, even though the subject had never been brought up before. According to Billy, Onision made it sound like that was always the plan from the beginning. In my first video on Onision, I covered the stories of the victims, including Billy. Billy posted a screenshot of a conversation on Twitter that Kai and Billy had, and as you can see, as Billy stated, the plan was just to date Kai and Onision was not to be involved. The conversation went as follows. Kai wrote, "I'm in a hetero relationship, but he is really supportive of me pursuing girls, just so you know. And like, not with him involved, just me, I hope that's okay with you." And then Billy responded, "Okay, good. I didn't want to overstep boundaries. Yes, that's perfectly okay with me." And then Kai said, "Yay! Ah, I'm really happy right now. Well, hi, I guess I should formally introduce myself. I'm Lainey." And then Billy responded, "Hello, I'm Billy. Tell me about yourself." Clearly, Onision was trying to manipulate Billy into thinking that they were always going to have a three-way relationship by trying to convince Billy that Billy was wrong, even though this conversation proved otherwise. Onision was persistent, and when Kai and Billy eventually hooked up, it also included Onision. Billy said that it sort of happened. Greg and Kai started kissing, and then Onision began telling Billy what to do. It wasn't forced, but Kai and Billy were definitely pressured into doing what he wanted them to do rather than doing their own thing. And after the first time, it became an everyday occurrence. Sarah came into the picture while Billy was still around, and they became friends. Billy stated that the physical relationship between Onision, Kai, and Sarah didn't start until after she left, but there was a time that Billy caught Sarah sitting next to the bathtub in the bathroom while Kai took a bath. Sarah was very underage at the time, and Billy felt that it wasn't the first time that that had happened. In 2016, Billy broke up with Kai and Onision for the last time. Onision had decided that he was going to do whatever he wanted in the three-way relationship, even without Kai's blessing. One day, Onision convinced Billy to sleep with him. Billy told Onision that Kai would not be happy about it, but he told Billy Kai was fine with it because they had talked about it beforehand. It turns out it wasn't fine. Kai got upset, and Onision blamed the whole thing on Billy, and so did Kai. Billy had had enough and walked away. Looking back on the situation now, Billy says that Onision knowingly, purposely exploited and manipulated them throughout the entire relationship. Onision would make Billy sign contracts he wrote up, tried to get her to shave her head in order to be forgiven, had insane rules, would share personal information about their relationship or her personal life, and he would also make videos about her when he was upset, sending his fans after her. Billy was extraordinarily brave to talk to Chris Hansen, and I applaud Billy's bravery. At the end of the interview, Chris Hansen asked if Billy was afraid of Onision, and Billy said yes because he's so unpredictable. And what happened after the interview, I understand why Billy would be. After Chris Hansen's interview with Billy, Onision took to Twitter and posted screenshots of conversations he's had with Billy in the past. Not only did he try to paint Billy in a certain way, but he also doxed Billy. He posted a text conversation and purposely left Billy's phone number visible for everyone to see. I didn't see the tweet myself because it was deleted, but I was able to find it, so thank you to the person who took this screenshot and edited out Billy's phone number. After being called out for the doxing, Onision eventually did delete the tweet, but the damage had been done. People were already trying to contact Billy. Patreon very quickly got wind that Onision had doxed Billy on Twitter and looked into the matter. After reviewing the evidence, Patreon made the decision to remove Onision's Patreon account. The Verge posted an article confirming his removal. The Verge wrote, "Yes, we removed Onision from Patreon. A Patreon spokesperson confirmed to The Verge that it considered those actions to be doxing, which violates its platform's rules and justified Onision's ban. Yes, we removed Onision from Patreon as he violated our bullying and harassment as it relates to doxing," a Patreon spokesperson told The Verge. "Patreon has a strict policy against doxing, even if it occurs outside the company's platform." I'll be sure to post a link to the article in the description box down below. As you can guess, a lot of us were overjoyed that Onision was finally deplatformed from at least one platform, and we celebrated by spreading the good news on all forms of social media. Even the victims took to Twitter to share their thoughts on the momentous occasion. Sky tweeted, "Hey Jeff, can you inform Onision that his Patreon page has been removed? Break it to him softly, as you're his only link to the real world. Thanks, bub." Shiloh wrote, "It seems Patreon has finally made a move. YouTube, when will you do the right thing? You've been rotting all this time on your own. Sooner or later, the vultures were going to pick you clean." Sarah tweeted, "I just got off work and found out Patreon took down Onision's page, and I'm like..." Sarah also tweeted, "You're effed." Haley wrote, "The fight is far from over, though. We aren't done here." So, Patreon removed Onision from their platform for doxing Billy on Twitter, but oddly enough, Twitter did not, even though what he did violated their privacy information policy. Their policy states that you may not publish or post other people's private information without their express authorization and permission. We also prohibit threatening to expose private information or incentivizing others to do so. Sharing someone's private information online without their permission, sometimes called doxing, is a breach of their privacy and of the Twitter rules. Sharing private information can pose serious safety and security risks for those affected and can lead to physical, emotional, and financial hardship. In Twitter's "What is in violation of this policy," it clearly states that contact information, including non-public personal phone numbers or email addresses. Onision publicly posted Billy's personal cell phone number. That is in clear violation of Twitter's policies, according to them. So what should have happened to Onision's Twitter account after he doxed Billy? According to Twitter, in their "What happens if you violate this policy" section, it says, "The consequences for violating our private information policy depends on the severity of the violation and the account's previous history of violations. The first time you violate this policy, we will require you to remove this content. We will also temporarily lock you out of your account before you can tweet again. If you violate this policy again after your first warning, your account will be permanently suspended. If you believe that your account was suspended in error, you can submit an appeal." So why in the heck was Onision still allowed to tweet even after he doxed Billy? According to Twitter, his account should have been temporarily suspended at the very least, but it wasn't. He was still posting ridiculous tweets and polls the following day and every day since. No repercussions for his actions at all. Twitter hasn't come forward with a formal statement as to why, but people have speculated that they didn't because he deleted the tweet before they even had a chance to review it. And honestly, if that's the case, that's crap, because he had it up for a while and people reported it multiple times, and there's plenty of screenshots to prove that he did tweet the tweet, but they'd probably say screenshots can be faked. It's a load of bull if you ask me. Why have rules if you're not going to enforce them, It shouldn't come as a shock to anyone that Onision was pretty upset that his main source of income was taken from him through no fault but his own. But that didn't stop him from posting a truly bizarre video of himself on YouTube going on a truly epic rant blaming all of us for him being deplatformed. He screamed at the camera claiming that since the FBI was not coming for him like we all wanted, that we decided to go for his paycheck instead, which apparently we got. He then proceeded to pour an entire bottle of kombucha over his head and then pretending to dry heave. It was really weird. At first I was shocked, thinking that maybe somehow it was real, but I quickly wised up and realized that he was simply doing it for attention. Do I think that his reaction to his Patreon being deleted was 100% fake? No, I do believe that under all the theatrics, there is genuine anger there. Now that his Patreon is gone, he has no choice but to rely on his Discord, YouTube channels, and even potentially Kai's Patreon if it's still up, but we'll discuss that later. Seeing that his first reaction video did so well, it currently has 756,000 views by the way, he has since uploaded 6 other videos, each one as crazy as the next. For some reason, he can't seem to keep his frickin' shirt on, loves channeling the Joker to seem even more insane, screams, yells, goes back to being seemingly normal before switching back to psycho and pretending to vomit. All of his videos gets hundreds of thousands of views, and that's why he's doing them. He knows everyone wants to see Onion Boy lose it. It's like a train wreck and everyone is rubbernecking. The first video, and maybe even the second, may have had the tiniest shred of realness to them, but the rest are 100% fake. After posting the first 2 videos, Haley took to Twitter and said, "Keep posting your psychotic meltdowns. The FBI and CPS are watching." If you're interested in watching these videos but you don't want to give him the view, there are several other channels out there with mirrored versions of his videos, and they are all over Twitter. The fact that these videos are even monetized is beyond me, yet most of us that talk about him are automatically demonetized even for mentioning his name. It's unbelievable. If you're like me and you've been following this story for quite a while, you are probably wondering where his 2 children are at during all of this, and like me are probably afraid for the safety and well-being of the innocent young children. I really hope that the 2 of them were not at home when Onision was filming these videos. Fake or not, young children should not have to see or hear any of that. Another concerned individual reached out to Regina regarding the children. They wrote, "Are there things being done to protect his children right now? Like Repsion, I'm a little concerned." And then Regina responded, "We are working on it. The last thing I want is people trying to take it into their own hands." And then the other person responded, "Exactly, thank you." Another concerned person tweeted, "There is an emergency plan to get the kids out of there, right? As someone who lived with an abusive, narcissistic ex of a YouTuber, it worries me. My dog became the target of violence when it all started coming to light, and he lost his job at the college I was at." And Regina responded, "All I can say is we are working on it." Regina then tweeted out the 2 following statements. "Calling CPS and the police is only going to harm what we are working on. I beg of everyone to just let us handle it. Do not give Greg attention. Let him be a freaking lunatic on his own. Do not try to take matters into your own hands. It is being handled behind the scenes. Trust me." I'm so grateful to Regina for letting us know that everyone is doing what they can to remove the young children from that household. I hope that if they aren't already, that they are taken in by loving family members soon. On November 27th, Chris Hansen interviewed a young woman by the name of Haley. Like the others, she found Onision by way of his YouTube channel at either 13 or 14 years old, but wasn't fully interested to the point of being a loyal fan until Kai came on the scene. Kai first noticed Haley when Haley posted a picture of herself wearing a Laneybot t-shirt on Twitter. Kai responded by saying that they were in love with Haley and then followed her on Twitter. After having yet another fight with Billy, Kai reached out to Haley on Twitter. A starstruck Haley was beyond ecstatic to have her idol reach out to her. After a short period of basic chit-chat, Kai asked Haley if she was into girls. It would seem that Kai was already over Billy and ready to move on. Their conversations were often flirty, and Haley was very flattered to be receiving such attention from a well-known YouTuber. But it wasn't all rainbows and butterflies. Haley mentioned that once she let both Kai and Onision know that she was not interested in a 3-way relationship, things started to change. Here is a conversation that Haley had with Onision once her mind was made up. Hey, I want you to know everyone's full intentions, and this just crossed my mind. When you're in a relationship with someone, you give them 100% of your relationship-related love to that one person. But when you're in Lainey's shoes, your heart gets divided. So say Lainey dates you. I now have a fraction of that attention I had before. A lot of people look at this situation and think, well, if you get a girlfriend, I'll get a girlfriend. But me doing successful Trinity is far more strong than a typical relationship for a number of reasons. Happy to go in depth down the line. Importantly, don't think you have to change what you're doing now. Just know that there is a good chance that once you're here, I will likely see you in a romantic way just like Lainey sees you, and it's okay to see us both romantically just so long as you don't forget Lainey is the priority for as long as I can foresee. What I mean by exclusive to each other is that we would all be only in a relationship with each other, the three of us collectively, although you and Lainey are free to express, do whatever you like with each other romantically, as Lainey with a woman she, I care about. It's beautiful to me. After some time had passed after the previous conversation, Haley did in fact decide that she did not want to be a part of a three-way relationship, and she let Onision know. Haley said, "Looking back on what I said, it seemed like it was just because of you, and that's not the case. I don't want a three-way relationship either. I feel like an a-hole, and I'm so sorry for the way it came across." Onision responded to Haley by saying, "Three-way relationships are awesome. They make you feel like you're a part of something bigger, and you just feel stronger overall. That and multiplayer video games are always better. There is the taboo factor. We just assume you didn't want to be a part of it because of your religion, which is a bad reason to avoid great potential for happiness on awesome levels." Haley responded, "And it sounded that way. It sounded amazing when you described it, but when I was digging deep within myself, I also realized that I want what you have. I want a family and a happy marriage. While I am Christian, that did not play a factor in my decision-making. I was basing everything off of my own feelings about it." Onision responded, "Is there something wrong with having a family with one father and two mothers?" And then Haley said, "Well, no, but I didn't think I could." Onision responded by saying, "I wouldn't want you to get into something that has a high risk of letting everyone else down, but the family is still possible with Lainey and the marriage." "Well, is Lainey not worth it?" Haley replied, "It's not what I want, though. That's the problem, too. It sounds amazing if it was with the right person, and I wish I could be okay with being that person. Lainey is definitely worth it, but I have to think of what I want for myself, too." Onision replied, "If she was worth it, you'd be all for it, because you would want it, because again, that is what being worth it means, but your position is clear. It's just odd you acted like it would work at first when you knew exactly what our intentions were before we all spoke in the first place." Haley replied, "Because I thought I could do it. I truly thought I could, and that I wanted it. I did. I swear I did. I wouldn't have continued talking to Lainey if I didn't." Onision said, "Okay, well, let's be clear. Lainey is not worth it to you. Otherwise, you would have moved forward, as that is what worth it means, so let's stop pretending. It's all okay, though, in the sense that we would not want you to be anything less than 100% in. I really believe you missed out, though. Maybe down the line you'll see that, but it will very likely be too late. Goodbye, Haley." Haley responded, "You're right. If Lainey was worth it to me, I would go through with it. And while I'm not okay with going through with it, I don't want that to mean that I don't have feelings for them, because I did. Very strong feelings. In the end, I had to be selfish with my feelings, though. This lifestyle isn't for everyone, which is why when I came to that conclusion last night, I wanted to tell you guys immediately. I hope you both don't hate me because of this. I still support you both a ton. I'm so sorry I've caused pain. Thank you for your time, Greg." We don't even remotely hate you. We're just bummed out you chose a generic cookie-cutter life over the awesome person she is, as we as the person you described to be handsome, whose personality you really liked. It just doesn't make sense. Turning away two people you really like for normality and the potential to hook up with some guy in a marriage that statistically is more likely to fail than succeed. If this is your gut talking, then go with your gut. Just know we do not at all hate you. It is your life and you want what you want. Haley replied, "It is my gut. Thank you for understanding. I wish you guys the best and I truly hope you find someone amazing to bring into your family. Thanks, Greg." Ugh, this conversation is just gross. It's blatantly obvious that Onision is trying to manipulate Haley into thinking that she's the problem and trying to guilt her into changing her mind. I tip my hat to you, Haley, for remaining strong. That could not have been easy. There are more conversations like this, and I can spend another 10 minutes reading them, but this video is getting long as it is. I advise you to check out Haley's Twitter account for the full receipts and also watch Chris Hansen's interview with her. I will say, however, that Haley told Chris Hansen that Onision told her that something must be wrong with her brain and that she had to be sexually dormant for not wanting to be involved in a three-way relationship. Onision also tried to get Haley to shave her head. I don't know what it is with him and shaving heads, but this is a common theme with him, and it's disturbing. Haley posted this conversation that she had with Onision. Onision wrote, "You won't get a name tattoo, and there is merit to that, but there would be no excuse for not shaving your head." Haley replied, "You think that I'm brave enough to do that? Why my hair?" Onision replied, "You lied to us repeatedly and abandoned us. If you really loved us, you would prove that you are sorry and that the relationship means more to you than something else important to you. So, shave your head." Again, I would literally do this in an instant if I were in your shoes. What the actual hell? Chris Hansen said it best. It's like he tried to create a cult or something. Onision is a sick, twisted monster. Even after all of that, Onision still considered flying Haley out to Washington to visit them just as friends, but Haley's mother wouldn't allow it. And Onision had been flip-flopping anyway, saying that it wasn't worth it for her to come out if she wasn't going to change her mind about the three-way relationship. I feel that it's important to know that all of this happened within a matter of 2 weeks. 2 weeks from start to finish. He tried to manipulate a young woman he and Kai had only known for 2 weeks into a three-way relationship. Disgusting. I am so glad that Haley's mother kept her from going to Washington. I'd hate to think of what could have happened if she went. So what's next for Onision now that his Patreon is gone? As I mentioned before, he is continuing to use his Discord, is uploading videos to YouTube, etc. I am worried that Onision may also try to take over Kai's Patreon, so I hope that if someone notices that he is, that they report the account as well so that it will be taken down. Patreon would not be pleased if they found out that Onision was being sneaky and trying to work his way around being banned. I do have some good news to report. Vincent Nicotra had a phone interview with fellow YouTuber Deity, and Vincent told him that the FBI is in now possession of a laptop, cell phone, and another mobile device, and the FBI is searching them for evidence of child P, among other things. I highly suggest you check out Deity's video, and I'll link it below. It was also made known on Twitter today that the FBI has officially opened an investigation into Onision and Kai, according to sources close to Vincent Nicotra. Chris Hansen is doing another live stream tonight, and hopefully we will receive more information regarding the FBI's involvement in the case. If Onision and Kai are indeed guilty of what they are being accused of, which I personally feel that they are, then it's only a matter of time before Onision and Kai are both deplatformed from all social media. Every day that goes by, we are that much closer to bringing Onision and Kai to justice. Onision likes to claim that because the FBI hasn't come for him yet, that he is safe. That is laughable to say the least. Newsflash, Onion Boy, the FBI won't come knocking on your door until they have all the evidence they need to build a solid case against you. The FBI doesn't take cases lightly, and you can bet when they come for you, you and Kai are in a world of crap. I look forward to the day when I see you dragged out of your home in handcuffs with Kai crying behind you. As always, I will keep a very close eye on this situation, and I will update you guys as the story progresses. That's gonna do it for today's video. I'd like to thank you all so much for spending some time with me today, and I hope you guys enjoyed the rest of your evening. Be sure to check out Chris Hansen's live stream if you have a chance to, and then also send Onision's victims some love. I really think that they could use some extra support right now. And also, if you are new here and you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Everyone give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you very shortly on the next one. Bye!